Welcome to Hi there, welcome to Nighttime Line Talks. Hola amigos, bienvenidos a Charlas de la Noche, Palabras con Imagen. Well, this is the second part about Guanajuato's and Nuevo León's elections coming on 2021. Why this broadcast is multilingual? I told you, it's focused initially for families that are multilingual. Parents speak Spanish, they don't have time to learn English, they are so busy working in the US, and kids are fluent in English, but both of them can listen this. Also, the main reason is because Mexico's investors are all over the world. These states I just mentioned, they are imperative and very important to determine the future of Mexico's in economics, in political, and in many fields. And regional politics are very shaky. Why? Because Mexico is part of the T-MEC, the former NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement. Well, that commercial agreement that is fully executed this coming July is leading many things on the regional economics for Canada, United States, and Mexico. And the influence of this agreement is going through the Patagonia. Yes, Colombia has an agreement with USA. Panama is very influenced by USA's through the Panamanian Canal. And there are many, many factors that this coming year are going to change with the election. But let's go to put in perspective the big picture from the previous program. I told you that in Guanajuato, that is one of the smallest states with more density of population. Guanajuato years ago was very important for agriculture. Guanajuato only had farms. But starting in the 1990s, Guanajuato started to have industry. Industry that influenced mostly in the auto making. Mazda, Toyota, General Motors, they are located in Guanajuato. Also, Guanajuato is a tradition on the shoes industry. That has years and years. León, Guanajuato is very positive in regard of the production of shoes. And they have wonderful leaders, entrepreneurs, wonderful people who bring jobs, not only to Guanajuato, to the whole center of Mexico. And that's the reason why we can't ignore this coming election. Already, Andrés Manuel López Obrador declared that they need to recover Guanajuato to consolidate his plans for Morena, the new party that has not solid foundation in politics, has no plans for economics, has no solutions for the big problems of Mexico. Morena is something that sounds familiar because it's a word that empathizes with the Mexicans. Morena means a nice lady with tan skin. That means Morena. And everybody correlates Morena with a cute Mexican lady. Is why the name becomes very positive in Mexican masses. They like it, they feel attracted with this name. Oh, Morena, immediately come to your mind, oh, I remember that cute lady in the school, Morena. So, but the leaders that Meg Morena leading by Andres Manuel López Obrador. They are defectors or quitters from another party that don't work. PRD, Partido de la Revolución Democrática. Initially, it was created by Cuauhtémoc Cárdenas and Porfirio Muñoz Ledo. I have very close relationship with Porfirio Muñoz Ledo. He is from my home state, Guanajuato. And Porfirio Muñoz Ledo is leading one of the cameras in Mexico for Morena. But he already criticized the president, and he told me he will not allow, even he is very ill and he moves in a wheelchair, and sometimes he will not allow Morena take the independence, the Mexican independence birthplace, Guanajuato. Guanajuato is the heart of Mexico. Guanajuato pumps products and revenue to many states, to Central Mexico, Querétaro, San Luis Potosí, Tamaulipas, and Nuevo León. What happens to it is, if you reference in your mind or in a map, geologically, this is an industrial chain between Central Mexico and the United States, because Nuevo León is border with the United States of America. And everything is important on this regard. Everything is part, an essential part, on the determination of the Mexican democracy. Justice, freedom of speech, freedom of press. Andrés Manuel López Obrador and his candidates has not endorsed the freedom of press. Recently, I mentioned the last program that Periódico Reforma, I used to work on that company, I am very glad and thankful they pay my college tuition, Hermanos Junco de la Vega, Rodolfo and Alejandro, and they receive a treat from one of the cartels. And people believe it because 2 months ago, Andrés Manuel López Obrador met with El Chapo Guzmán's mother. And last May, last year, Andrés Manuel López Obrador and the Mexican army released Ovidio Guzmán, who was detained by the armed forces, but they give the arm to twist, with no authority, breaking the principles of the legal normativity. They release criminals. They release people who murdered thousands of Mexicans and American citizens. That has no name. Andrés Manuel López Obrador has no authority to do that. And many of the organizations in the world, Human Rights Watch, many organizations, Mother Against Drug Dealers, and many are organizing to make a front to avoid Andrés Manuel López Obrador come back to power, or his party keep staying on the power. Why? Because he is endorsing the drug traffickers. He plays back them on the streets, and they give all facilities to traffic with drugs, to laundry money, to make people feel intimidated. Yes, they send their gunmen to houses and intimidate relatives. I recently can tell you about a very, very close experience. And that has no name. and these lips will not stop Mr. Andrés López Obrador. This program is produced in the United States, and many friends, journalists, Alfredo Corchado, Dallas Morning News, Larry Roeder, New York Times, people that works on the White House, people that works on the television, CNN, Michael Hessin, CNN, Ted Rubinstein, senior correspondent David Martin, a great fan, and he always sponsors me. I assist him in many projects. So don't play games with journalists. We are professional. We are not Prensa Fifi. We are not people that you criticize every day. We do a serious work, professional, based in facts. What I just mentioned is facts. You release criminals, you help their families, and you are breaking the legal normativity of Mexico, and you like to impose candidates that you can manipulate like a Muppets. I don't know where you put the hand, but you move them at your own convenience. It must to be stopped as soon as possible, because also Mexican businessmen are not quiet. They are not happy with your attitude. They are not happy. What are you doing? In my native Guanajuato, there is a lead group of businessmen, former governor Carlos Medina Plasencia, owner of Medina Torres, one of the largest companies on the shoes industry. He is leading a big group of entrepreneurs. They are not asking your permission. They are not telling you. And the government of Guanajuato has problems because you tolerate criminals back to the streets. It's not the state government of Diego Sinhoe who is making mistakes. It's Andrés Manuel López Obrador. I interviewed a colleague, journalist, last year, because obviously I don't live in Guanajuato, I need to have perspective from others to understand the problematic. And Mr. Cuellar, who was director before he was a journalist in AM, the most largest and read a newspaper in Guanajuato. After that, he quit and he goes to the official newspaper. And after that, he creates his own news and opinion company. Mr. Arnoldo Cuellar criticized the criminals operating in Guanajuato. And that's true. That is affecting all of them. And he that the government is not working enough to stop them. After that broadcast, I start to search over, and some authorities told me that they are doing statewide, and municipalities are doing their job. What is happening is mayors that belong to Morena, sponsored by Guardia Nacional, allow criminals to come back to the oil lines, break the oil lines to steal gasolines and gas and stuff like that. And it's an endless problem. Mexican army has a huge problem in Guanajuato. Chaotic, because it's the place where the Mexican independence begins. And Andrés Manuel López Obrador is thirsty to have that state under his control. Yes! He's thirsty, but Grupo León is not allowing him to take over. Even his web of manipulation and intimidation is working. No, many people is becoming together from Guanajuato through Nuevo León, and it's not easy to they allow what one single president is trying to do to destroy the economy, to destroy the social peace of the country, and giving the control back to the most criminal drug dealers in the world. And those drug dealers now are associated with terrorists from Iran and Venezuela, Cubans, to come to Mexico and do crime and intimidate people. Stop your games, Andrés Manuel López Obrador. You are not a kid. If you can manipulate your Muppets there, Alfonso Romo, Tatiana Cloutier, Ramon Alberto Garza, and some congressmen, they already turn around and say, stop. Porfirio Muñoz Ledo is one of them. And he's not a quitter. He is a Mexican, an honest Mexican who has a clear idea of the judicial, legislative, and the executive government in Mexico. He knows from the legal perspective exactly where are you breaking the law every day. And he's not crossing his hands. He's putting everything in writing, because one day he is going to accuse you legally with all the points, the legal points on his hands, because you are manipulating many agencies of the government to intimidate people, to do tax hunting, intimidating people. You already sent a huge list of names. Let me tell you to which one agency, because I have here in my files. I was noticed by employee of Gobernación, the Interior Department, that is from my hometown, and he can't believe it, what you are doing. Let me tell you, because I like to read it straight. You call the Tribunal Federal de Justicia, Federal Fiscal y Administrativa, you call the Tribunal Federal de Justicia, Fiscal y Administrativa, a department from the Justice Department in Mexico that you manage, you manipulate, and that's illegal. Yes, you call it, and you send a list of your enemies to start to prosecute about taxes. Yes, you are putting on that list, and I'm going to tell the details, because the Interior Department, not all the people is with you, as well not the army is with you, as well not the magistrates in the courts are with you. They are mad, and shame on you, because you are doing a lot of mistakes, Mr. López Obrador. Pedro Luis Martín Bringas, co-owner of Soriana. Soriana are grocery stores in Mexico that owns 700 stores, 800. They are the second distributors of groceries after Walmart. Well, the owner of this business is asking to Mr. Andrés Manuel López Obrador, demise from power, because he is not working according the legacy of the Mexican Constitution. You send his name to this tribunal and begin an investigation about the Soriana gift cards were delivered previous campaigns as a motivation, as a souvenir to attract votes. What is completely illegal. Many candidates give hats, t-shirts, many things to attract voters, and that is legal because they only do on the campaign times. Well, you names of Alejandro Junco de la Vega and his co-owners of Grupo Reforma and start to develop a fiscal investigation against him and his partners. Sad. Very sad. And the list is huge. You start to send and request every owner, including the ones that sponsor you. You force the owner of a largest phone company in Mexico, partner of Carlos Salinas de Gortari, your political enemy number one. You force him to intrude the phone lines and tape conversations of your political enemies to have an idea and know what they are doing. I crystal clear, the owner of this company, honestly, he doesn't agree to do that because it's against the law. But you send people to force him, and you are taping conversations in Mexico from many of your enemies. Illegal. Also, you are chasing Beatriz Pajes Yergo, a very traditional and very well-known and respected journalist, a lady that is with a huge background on the Mexican journalism. Her father, Don José Pajes Yergo, was my teacher, the owner of Revista Siempre, Always Magazine, to translate for all of you. And you are chasing and taping all her conversations. That's not clean. That's not democracy. That's not justice, Mr. López Obrador. And you are doing the same thing against the personnel of the American embassy in Mexico. You are chasing them. You are betraying the only politicians that sponsored you, Donald Trump. You are betraying him. Alfonso Romo at the beginning was qualified, in his team, Ramon Alberto Garza, Tatiana Cloutier, was qualified as a betrayer because your policies are against Mexico. But no, they ratify that they like to help you. And they endorse many things you are doing, obviously. Of course, Alfonso Romo is acquiring the water rights. Every water source that is underground in Mexico, this man has companies that put machinery and they start to take the water to industries to sell on barrels and to charge money to farmers who want to use that water. Your main partner, Manuel Bartlett, who was on the same party that you were coming from, Interior Director, he manipulates the international help other governments sent to Mexico when the 1985 earthquake, and Mexicans cannot receive food, cannot receive tents, cannot receive sleeping bags and medications. Everything was stolen. And what happens now, 40 years later? His son, Manuel Bartlett Jr., steals the machines, the respirators, American government sent to Mexico, and he is selling to the Mexican authorities with overlap prices, out of context. That is your corruption, Andrés Manuel López Obrador. I have nothing against you, Mexican president. I have nothing against your team. but you are abusing the power. What Manuel Bartlett Diaz knows about you that you don't take him out of your political team? The interior departments of the Mexican administrations manage a lot of intelligence. They manage the army, the marines, the Department of Justice, everything. They know intelligence. They know how you help some lefty groups in the 70s as a co-participant, helping Luis Echeverria against businessmen. The representative businessmen that put Mexico in the map of international business. And you help them. Somebody is going to point out that it's not my job to do that. But somebody is working on that. Andrés Manuel López Obrador was telling on his 12 years campaign that he will restore the peace in Mexico, that he will restore the economy, that he will fix many of the problems on the social fabric. What happens after 2 years he takes the power? He made them worse. Economy is on zero. There is not growth. And everyone who brings that under his attention, everybody who tells that to his administration, is start to be chased. I know my name is also there. My editorial partner is also there. When you start your administration, I send you a book with good wishes, telling you that in sometimes we like to include you in some programs. You never answer. And I have the receipt of Federal Express. The book was delivered in your office with your signature. My editorial partner, Placido Garza, went at National Palace to attend the morning briefing. Every day you held, he was taken out. You don't allow him. Why? Because he is independent journalist like me. You only like the official press, you manipulate, and you manage bloggers, video bloggers, etc. And the day Ricardo Rocha questioned your body language, your face expression, shows your answers. As well you did with the journalist of Reforma, this nice lady. I don't have her name right now in my mind. But everybody remembers that video. But let me tell you something, Mexican president. You narcotized the Mexican public opinion with that morning show and with the evening show. Now nobody believes you anymore. And it's evident you are doing a very job in Guanajuato to take over this state. As well, you are doing very jobs in Nuevo León, where you sent a couple weeks ago Alfonso Romo to talk with businessmen and entrepreneurs to intimidate them. But there is a way when Alfonso Romo, Tatiana Cloutier, Ramon Alberto Garza see all your dirty jobs becomes out and exposed internationally, nobody's going to protect you. They are going to quit. They are quitters already. Basically, some of your people call them the Trojan horse. But they are with you still because they like the business you are giving them. Business that are considered by analysts illegal and business that are privileged, where resources are natural and belongs to the patria, to the homeland. How in the hell you are commercializing everything? The economy is passing you an invoice, a very tough invoice, because you don't like to invest, you don't like to accept help to grow the economy and bring business. Japanese investors are worried about what's going on with your government, and they have a huge investment in Guanajuato on the car plants, as well many other business are concerned. And if you go from Guanajuato to San Luis Potosí, in San Luis Potosí is a company that manufactures everything for Las Vegas, chips, tables, everything. It's a huge business. Well, your tax chasers are affecting that business, as well many other business through the Nuevo León. You like for your party every part of the Mexican territory. But businessmen, entrepreneurs, people who see fruitless results from your political platform is understanding that you are following the plans you have learned from Fidel Castro in Cuba in the 70s, where you were trained, endorsed by Evo Morales and Hugo Chavez, who give you money to keep fighting when you were 12 years in campaign against other candidates. And you have no mercy. You have no sensibility and common sense to develop a natural policies that meet the people's expectations. That is not true. People is sad, the poor are more poor. You are creating a poison generation of young people, giving them free money, and they don't study, they don't work. What happens when that people don't meet the age standards to keep receiving money and they have to work? They are becoming against you because you are promising too much things. And every promise is not solid. You have no resources. You are taking good money to put on the bad projects, and that money is not recovered. That is the beginning of your end, of your policies, of your mentality. And Mexicans are tired of you, Mr. Andrés Manuel López Obrador. You have a good team. Some of your people are bright. And what happens? You start to fire the good ones and keep the bad ones. So you need to make an introspection, because people start to say your free fall begins releasing El Chapo Guzman's song and has no end. It is an endless fall. Even on the military, I have friends on the military. You are giving them a lot of work, you pay them very well, they are not happy. Many militaries comes to the School of Las Americas in Columbus, Georgia, here, 300 miles from where I am seated. They receive special courses, training, survivals, whatever. Now, you stop you stop that project because you say that it's against the human rights. A military who experienced that course are talking about that your point is because you don't like to do anything against the mobs of the drugs. You like to fill United States with drugs and make the problem of drugs consumption worse. That is your dream. What is, that is what you want. And you use the migrant caravans from Central America, sponsored by George Soros, who pays part of your campaign, who gives you a lot of cash money, to sponsor your totalitarianism. George Soros, even he born on one of the Russian territories, is not welcome on those territories. George Soros is manipulating you and the world with lies, with intimidation, with many, many fake policies. But that situations are going to become public very soon. And then what are you telling to the Mexicans that trust in you? What's your answer, Mr. Andrés Manuel López Obrador? Porfirio Muñoz Ledo revealed part of it. He's not with you. And you were losing sponsors. You were losing support. What you are trying to do in Nuevo León, making an espionage of high level, taping conversations to the businessmen. Many of the businessmen are doing their own to communicate themselves because they figure out your dirty jokes, your dirty plans. They are encrypting their phone lines. They are doing in a very safe way their connections because they know you get help from that partner who clapped you every day to take conversations. And you are doing many, many things that are not honest. And I'm not telling that. The facts, the comments from people reveal that. And don't go and intimidate the Interior Department employees. They are young, some of them are good people. Don't go and intimidate the Mexican army. They know what they are doing. But they say that you are breaking one word with your actions. And it's coming from top rank generals. You have no legacy, Andrés Manuel López Obrador, to stay representing the authority of the Mexican government. You don't sponsor in a law and order state. You are giving the control to drug dealers. They are out on the streets delivering food to the people, toys. Oh, they are very good. And you clap. You are happy. You agree that. Why? Because it's part of your manipulation. And now that the cartels called to media, newspapers, and journalists to intimidate them, you say nothing. Oh, no. A phone call, who cares? And the reason of this broadcast in English is because there are thousands of American investors, thousands of Japanese investors, thousands of the European Community investors that must know the truth that is underground, under your government, under your fake policies, under your fake promises. Yeah. You like to destroy Alejandro Junco de la Vega? You like to find him in a dumpster? Is what you say one day out of the record? Is where you want to find Alejandro Junco de la Vega, con la basura? Ahí lo quieres ver? Because is where he belongs, porque es donde le corresponde estar. A president who says that is not president. La señora Pajés, Mirces Beatriz Pajés Yergo, is a nice lady. And there are millions of Mexicans that will take care to protect her in the United States and in Mexico. And I made you responsible, Andrés Manuel López Obrador, if something happens to this lady or her family. Remember the 70s. You are correlated to many situations. And history has mine. Pedro Martín. Pedro Luis Martín Bringas. Nice entrepreneurs. That dedicates his whole life to create jobs and make the Mexican productivity strong. He is telling you, you must demise from the government. Do it tastefully. You are not created for this job. Enough is enough, Andrés Manuel López Obrador. Don't intimidate people. Don't use those government offices to create taxes and try to create problems. You are a troublemaker. But the truth is already on the public opinion. You cannot change your image. Intimidating, using Cuban spies, using terrorists from Iran, training the drug dealers from Sinaloa Cartel and Cartel Jalisco Cuarta Generación or whatever. That's not honest. A government that lay down and cross his knees with the criminal organizations is not a government. So you don't have a government, Mr. Andrés Manuel López Obrador. You have no authority. You have no respect. And all your dirty jobs in Guanajuato and Nuevo León are over. Earlier or later, many people is going to act. And Mexicans are not alone. Mexicans talk. You are the next door of the main country in the world, United States of America. Do you believe that they don't care? Remember how they take out Manuel Noriega. Couple hours, problem solved. Who cares? Andrés Manuel López Obrador, you are holding an office. You are controlling criminals. You are manipulating and intimidating people. But you are not the president. You are criminal like them. Why? Because it is a cohecho. A person who helps and protects drug dealers and criminals. You know, you are an attorney. You know what I'm talking about. You are breaking the laws. And all that people that you poison their minds with $200 a month, earlier or later, are going to realize that same situation. Andrés Manuel López Obrador. somebody has to pull out all that crap and honestly it's better that you go home, stay with your wonderful family, my respect for your wonderful wife, your kids, and if you do an introspection and recognize that you make mistakes. Yes, I make mistakes. You do mistakes. Everybody make mistakes. But some mistakes are beyond the law and order. And this is what you are doing. Mistakes that they are breaking apart a Mexican society, a country, destroying the economy, destroying the peace of a beautiful country that is example worldwide on traditions, on food, on culture. Oh, beautiful Mexico. And only Mexicans are the ones who are going to judge you. Even some people in other countries all over the world already are pointing the fingers to you because you are jeopardizing their investments. There is a German citizen in Puebla who was tortured and torched. Miko, I forgot the name. A German friend called me and tell me the information. And it's documented on the Puebla's television. The team of people, policemen you send to intimidate people is working against foreigners or against your enemies, against many people that you don't like in Mexico. And Angela Merkel received a report of that. And you are going to receive a diplomatic note on that regard. Stop all that, Mr. President. Many situations are hidden. You don't allow it. Obviously, you have in Puebla a friend of as governor. What happens with the former lady governor? She passed away in an accident, mysteriously. Now one of your friends is on the government. And what happens? This gentleman complained that being tortured, and they put him in a car because they like to take him in a clandestine jail. Fortunately, many people take videos with the cell phones, and that helps him a lot. But German intelligence send their agents to investigate the case. And guess what they found? All your crap behind that. Mr. Andrés Manuel López Obrador. People around the world is watching and listening what you are doing. And your government don't respect democracy, don't respect social peace, don't respect entrepreneurs, and don't respect international people that goes to do business with Mexico. Lord bless you, and I hope this message can help you to recapacitate and change. And never is too late to understand the reality and quit. Quit is the best solution for you. Because you make too many mistakes. You make too many compromises with mobs, with criminals, with the most dangerous people in the world. For the safety of the country, let people run a new clean election. Thank you. Have a good night. Lord bless the world. Lord bless Mexico and Lord bless America.